A blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. Today, we celebrate the solemnity of the Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, Sanctuary Patroness of the Diocese of Bacolod. We also celebrate today the Indigenous People Sunday and Extreme Poverty Day. Let me read to you the letter number 2021-021 from the Roman Catholic Bishop of Bacolod, Diocese of Bacolod. Greetings. The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines Episcopal Commission on Indigenous Peoples has set this year's celebration of Indigenous People Sunday on October 10, 2021. The CBCP has given us a two-year theme, Dialogue, Communion, and Mission with Indigenous People, which started last year and will end on the eve of next year's celebration. In this regard, I hereby call on our parishes and chaplaincies to organize a second collection in all anticipated and Sunday Masses on October 9 and 10, respectively. With my prayers and pastoral blessing, Patricia A. Buzon, SDBDD, Bishop of Bacolod, by order of His Excellency, Reverend Father Roy Christian Yusulcon, Chancellor, Secretary. Dear brothers and sisters, the whole Diocese of Bacolod celebrates the solemnity of her secondary patroness, the Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary. The Blessed Mother is our sure intercessor at all times, especially in this difficult time of pandemic. Let us then bring to her motherly intercession all our hopes and dreams in life. We also remember our own tribal and poor Filipinos' aspirations for improvement of their material and cultural conditions in celebration of the Indigenous People Sunday and Extreme Poverty Day. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Roy Christian Yusulcon.
Of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to be.
Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord,
your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, by his passion and cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
The fidelity of our Blessed Mother in God's mission is clearly shown in this reading as she continues to accompany the disciples. The first reading.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had been taken up to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying. Peter and John, James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All this devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women and Mary, the mother of Jesus and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Almighty.
God justified his chosen people to be like his only Son. They who were set apart will share his glory. The second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Sisters and brothers, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to conform to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among his brothers. For those he predestined, he also called. For those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Today we commemorate two things. First, we are celebrating in the Diocese of Bacolod the solemnity of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, a second patroness of the Diocese of Bacolod. And also we are to remember Indigenous People Sunday and Extreme Poverty Day. How can we relate the two things that we are to consider? Well, my dear friends, God's greatness and God's actions can best be experienced in our own human experience of our lowliness, our poverty. And that is where Our Lady proclaims the greatness of God. She proclaims the greatness of God, for that greatness is made manifest in her own poverty. For the Lord has made great things possible for her, and holy is His name. And at the same time, Our Lady expresses in her song, for He has looked with favor on His lowly servant. Lowliness, poverty, that is where God's power is made manifest. My dear friends, that is also true to our experience when we go through the difficulties of life, especially in this great time of distress brought about by COVID-19, we are also to experience God's power. And that is what our psalmist gives us. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is His name. And that is what we also hear from the Gospel of Luke. His mercy is there for all generations. He has shown the strength of His arm. He scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. The theme of God's greatness in relation to man's poverty. My dear friends, in our Gospel for today, we see how in the life of Mary becomes concrete God's greatness and her poverty. And it's not only in the life of Mary, but likewise in the life of the one who is also close to Mary, in the life of Elizabeth. I'd like to quote that part of the Gospel of Luke where God meets the poverty of Elizabeth. And the angel said, "Therefore the child to be born shall be called Son of the Most High, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Barrenness, the phase of Elizabeth's poverty. Tika namin, no? Ang Diyos naga-interact sa aton. Ang Diyos nga naga-abot sa aton. Ang Diyos nga naga-igo sa atong kabuhi, labi na gid kung sa diin kita pobre. Poverty of man, greatness of God. And it is expressed beautifully by Mary when she said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. I am at your disposal." And interestingly, St. Luke provides us a fitting ending to this meeting of God's greatness and man's poverty. "Then the angel departed from her." Kad naglakat ang anghel, matapos niya nahatag ang mensahe. How many times in our own experience of poverty and barrenness that we are focused more on that, nga doon naglakat ang anghel, nga nagbaya ang Diyos, nga wala di ang Diyos kay naglakat na siya. When we could have seen it the other way around, that before the angel left, the angel gave us something to live by. That before the angel left, the angel already made sure that we have everything that we need to live through the experience. Kung kisa ang aton focus niya ang pagbaya, why kita'y nag-focus sa
presensya naging bilin sang siya naglakat. Pero actually, wala magit siya naghalin. Nagpabilin siya. It's no surprise that the name of Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us. My dear friends, in our difficulties, at times we long for that presence because we thought that that presence left us. And I find solace in the very example of St. Paul in the second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verse 9, where he said that the Lord has communicated to Paul as he experiences all the problems of life and he was struggling within himself, and he heard the words from the Lord, "My grace is sufficient for you." Beautiful. A feeling nato, nano ni Lord, yung pabayaan mo kami. Nano ni Lord, naglakat ka na. Nano ni Lord. Pero gali, ang Diyos is a God who is provident. He has left us with the necessary grace, and I would say even graces that we need so that we can survive through the experience. When we experience our poverty, it is actually an invitation and call for us to rediscover that grace that the Lord assures that He will give, and He has not failed in giving us when we need it the most. My grace is sufficient for you. And in the Gospel of Luke, that is given to us with another face, when the angel said that Mary is to be full of grace. And what is this grace? The grace of an accompanying presence. A presence that has not actually left us. A presence that is there for us every step of the way in the journey. My dear friends, it is good that we are celebrating the feast, rather a solemnity of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, because it reminds us of that presence which has become a gift for us, that through Mary, God's presence even more is appreciated by His children. God has given us a mother, and that motherly presence has accompanied us since day one of the life of the Church. In our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, we have seen that after Jesus has ascended into heaven, the Church was left with a motherly presence. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying, Peter and John, James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus and His brothers. Beautiful. An accompanying presence. In our experience of COVID-19, COVID has, in a sense, brought us to our knees and brought us to really face another aspect of human poverty, and that is the poverty of relations, the poverty of being alone, the poverty of being isolated. Mugi na siguro pinaka subo na klase sang poverty, a poverty of loneliness. And here God assures us of an accompanying presence. And we see Mary, day one in the life of the church, being there for her children. And the presence of Mary is embedded in the very mysteries that we contemplate when we pray the rosary. She accompanied her son through the way of the cross. Mary was there every step of the way. And so it is also not a surprise that she accompanies her children as mother of the church. Interestingly, when we look at the history of this feast, we come across the Battle of Lepanto as a determining event why this feast came to be. Pope Pius X, was instrumental also during that Battle of Lepanto when he called on this Holy Fleet to battle against the Ottoman Empire, which is threatening Europe at that time. Though far superior, the fleet of the Ottoman Empire, and less superior is the power of the European Christians, they found power by praying the rosary. And at the end of the day, the Ottoman Turks were defeated through the power of the rosary. Mary accompanied her children to win that battle. And in the history of the church, you have so many apparitions to show Mary's motherly presence. You have also the apparition at Fatima, where a lady was deeply concerned that it would seem that people simply fall into hell like leaves falling in the autumn. And thus she was asking, pray the rosary for conversion. Mary's accompanying presence. My dear friends, as we celebrate her solemnity in the Diocese of Bacolod, and as we connect it to the celebration of Indigenous People Sunday, an extreme poverty day, we look into our own poverty and see God's greatness at work. A greatness that is shown to us through an accompanying presence. We are not alone in our struggles. We are not alone in our problems. We are not alone given the daunting tasks ahead. We are with God. And that assurance is further bolstered by the faith that is expressed to us by Saint Paul himself in our second reading, in his letter to the Romans, that in the end, we are predestined to greatness, that those whom God predestined, he shall also glorify. Our strength, our power lies when we don't forget the accompanying presence, which is truly grace that is from our God. And so, my dear friends, yes, we are going through difficult times, and we hold on to the best weapon that we have, the rosary, the mysteries. Let us be one with Mary, who found strength in God's presence as she went through the highs and lows of her own life. Para sa ato ng mga tao, kanami na sa kabuhi, may kinakapyutan kita. No? Kung ang tanan nagakalatumba, kung ang tanan do hindi stable, kanami na may kinakapyutan kita. Kag isa sa mga kinakapyutan naton, ang rosarito. Ang rosarito, kung sa diin, ang aton kabuhi, nagasanto man sa kabuhi sa mahal nga Iloy, kung sa diin ang kabuhi, isa kabuhi na pwede padayunon kung ara lang gid ang Dios nga nagaupod sa aton. We find strength in the power of the mysteries of the Rosary, where God's greatness meets human poverty, where God's greatness meets our own experience of poverty. Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us. Amen. We now rise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Amen. My dear friends, God our Father chose Mary to be our model, doing his will and in serving our poor brothers and sisters. Through Jesus, born of her, we ask the Heavenly Father to grant our prayers as we say, Lord, hear us with the intercession of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary.
Lord, hear us with the intercession of the Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
For the Church, especially the Diocese of Bacolod, that through the motherly support of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may follow her virtues as our guide to attain life eternal. We pray.
Lord, hear us with the intercession of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
For the leaders of our country, especially those who filed their candidacy for the upcoming election, that they should always prioritize the common good and the welfare of the people over their self-vested interests. We pray.
Lord, hear us with the intercession of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
For those who suffer because of extreme poverty, the persecuted indigenous people, and those who are stricken of the COVID-19, that their hope for God be strengthened to our help. We pray.
Lord, hear us with the intercession of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
For every family and Christian community in our diocese who pray their Holy Rosary, that they may remain united with one another and strengthened in faith against the evils that destroy their love and holiness, We pray.
Lord, hear us in the intercession of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
For our beloved departed, that through the motherly help of the Blessed Mother, they may at least come to the place of eternal peace and joy. We pray.
Lord, hear us with the intercession of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
Loving Father, through the intercession of Our Lady of the Most Holy Rosary, let no prayers be left unanswered and no petitions be left unheard through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may be rightly conformed to these offerings we bring, and so honor the mysteries of your only begotten Son, as to be made worthy of His promises, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, the blessed seraphim, worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Oh,
are indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, Vicente, their Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, Saint John of the Cross, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now call upon God, our Father.
Thank you.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Friends, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen. Please all rise.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord our God, that just as we proclaim this sacrament, the death and resurrection of your Son, so being made partakers in his suffering, we may also merit a share in his consolation and his glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Please all kneel for the mission prayer. God, our loving Father, you sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news of salvation to all, to sinners, the poor, oppressed, the sick, the abandoned and neglected. He gave his life on the cross for us and rose again to new life, to redeem us and reconcile us with you. You sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles to continue the work of your Son and to lead all to salvation. We thank you, Father, for bringing us from darkness into light through your loving plan 500 years ago. Missionaries came to our land to proclaim the gospel of Jesus, your Son, to our ancestors, that made us your people and the church. The gift of faith has accompanied us through both darkness and light, defeats and victories of our history as your people. Our faith has become for us true light that shines in the darkness. Renew in us the grace of your Spirit that impels us to be witnesses of Jesus, your Son, to a world broken by greed, violence, injustice, sickness, and suffering. May our faith bring us to unity as your children, to care for and love one another. May the Holy Spirit empower us to be proclaimers of the good news to our brothers and sisters in Asia and to all nations. Give us the sincere desire to help others to come to faith in the Lord Jesus, to share in your joy and life. May the Blessed Mother, the star of evangelization, accompany us and pray for us as we live and share our faith with others. May our strong love and devotion to her as our Mahal na Ina form us to be true disciples and witnesses of Jesus to all, always ready to be sent and to be obedient to whatever Jesus asks of us. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We shall now sing the Salve Regina. Please all rise.
Thank you.
kindly be seated for a while. We would like to invite you to celebrate with us the feast of Saint Teresa of Avila with a Triduum of Masses this coming October 12 to 14, that is from Tuesday to Thursday, and on the feast itself on October 15, Friday. All the Masses will be at 6:30 in the morning with our Carmelite Fathers as our main celebrants and homilists. As we do every day, all the Masses will be live streamed at 6:30 in the morning through the new Bacolod Channel 6 and at 10 o'clock in the morning through Facebook or YouTube channel of Carmel Bacolod. Thank you, and may God bless us all. Please all rise.
Just an announcement, the Holy Father has called for a synod on synodality, and yesterday the process has already started in Rome. It's a three-year journey on synodality. By October, we'll also have our diocesan pre-synodal processes. We will start October 17, so there will be a launching of the pre-synodal journey in the Diocese of Bacolod October 17 at the San Sebastian Cathedral. Plans are still in the works. So from October all the way to September, October 2021, all the way to September 2022, there will be pre-synodal processes in the diocesan level. By September 2022 to March 2023, it will be elevated to the bishops' conferences and the continental level. And by October 2023, there will be the 16th Ordinary Synod of Bishops on Synodality. That is the call of the Pope, a church for a synodal church, mission, communion, participation, and mission. So we pray together with the Universal Church as we look into our journey towards synodality, as we journey together in faith. I'll now give the blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your loved ones, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.